Hello, I'm going to show you how to bring open-ended survey to NVivo. How do you do that? So as you can see here, I've already brought it. So I'm going to show you the final product before I show you how to do it. As you can see here, I have my survey data here with demographic information and also open-ended responses. When you double click on it, you can see that I have it in like a spreadsheet. So I have all the demographic information and also the open-ended response here. I can start the coding process by selecting and creating codes and then dropping these information to the code. You can also see here when you go to cases, you can see all the participants. When you go to coding and you click on this arrow, you can see that all the open-ended questions, right, are here. And then when you double click on it, you see the question here, and these are their responses, right? So the system was able to group participant responses under the questions that we asked them. So how do you do all these things in Mac? First, let me try and open a new project. So I go to Control N. So you open a new project and then you can give it a name. I'll type here project. Maybe six, right? And then I type the same here to project title, project six, and I click on create project. So this is the open project, right? So there's no information here. Now what we have to do is to upload this open-ended survey. Let me quickly show you how the open-ended survey looks like. As you can see here, I have my spreadsheet about the survey. So you can see here there's a demographic information. The first column is about participant ID, so P1, P2, P3. It's very important to put the participant ID in the first column, right? Then the second column is the age, gender will be in the next one, years of experience, ethnicity, and also the question that was asked participants and also their responses. These are the questions, and then when you come down here, these are their responses. So these are the information that we're going to upload. Make sure you close it before you upload. So what you have to do is that you have to click on data set, and then you look for the data that you want to bring in. We select that and then we click on open. So here you don't have to do much here. So you go to next. You have to make sure that the first column is the participant ID, right? That is the, will be the identifier. That's the information that will help you to do the classification. So if you do it this way, we're going to use the participant ID to create cases for each participant. And when we start creating the cases, you will see what I'm talking about. You click on next and then click on import. So as you can see here, I have my survey here. You have the demographic information and also you can have the survey responses. One thing that we have to think about is that you can do the coding process by opening this, right? So let me close it and show you how to open. You can double click on it and then you open and you can start the coding process by going to code here. And then you can develop containers here, right? Or codes, and then select and then drag and drop into that container, right? If you want to learn about how to code, I have other videos there to help you. This is more about showing you how to set everything up to start the coding process when you have open-ended survey. You can do the coding here, or there's another way of doing that which I like, where you ask the system to group participant responses based on the survey open-ended questions that you have. All these responses will go under this question. All these responses will go under that question. So how do you do that? We go to code, control click, and then you click on new folder. And this is what you're going to type, open-ended responses. So this is where we're going to group all the open-ended responses under the question. So you click on done, and then you see the folder here. We go back to files. And we're going to use the autocode function to help us to group all the open-ended responses and bring them into this folder, right? So what you're going to do is that control click, and then you go to autocode data set. And here you can code to code for selected columns. So this is what you have to choose. So you see here that your survey questions are on top here, and the system is going to group the responses under each of the survey questions. So the survey question technically is going to be the code, and then participant response will be the coded set, right? But don't worry about the names. The most important is that you are trying to group participant responses under their respective questions that was asked. And so we go to the next. So you have selected all the open-ended questions that was asked, right? If you are not interested in any of them, you can bring it back here, right? So that the system will not deal with that question. So we are interested in all of them, so we just leave them here at the selected columns. And then we go to next. So here under the code, the location, this is where you choose the folder that we created, right? Because we want to put everything under this folder, right? So the open-ended responses folder, we select that. And then we can also check aggregate coding from chat. It's not really useful, but you know, we can check it for now. Maybe it will be useful later. We click on auto code. As you can see, it has finished. So if you click on open-ended responses and go to the arrow here, you can see that all the open-ended questions have been brought here. And when you double click, you can see participant response for each of them, right? So this one, open-ended question that was asked, do you experience burnout at work? And these are the responses, right, from participant. If you finish reviewing this one, you can close it. You can close this one too, and then you can double click on the second one. So you see how the system has grouped the responses based on a question that was asked. This is an easier way of doing the coding, right? So you can easily code it from here instead of going to the spreadsheet and starting the coding. Now you look at their responses and then start the coding process. What you can do if you want to code is that you can click here and then you can create containers for the research question, and also you create code, and then you'll be able to start the coding process from here. Now that we have brought all the participant open-ended responses to one place, another thing that we may have to also do is we want to create containers for each of the participants, because when you start the coding process, we will not know the source. So it's very important to create cases for them and also connect the cases to their demographics and their responses. I'm going to show you how to do that before you start the coding process. So you click on files and you can press up control and click and go to auto code data set. This time you are not choosing the first option, you're going to choose the second option because we want to create cases for each of the participants. So you see here the code that we give participants, p1, p2, p3. This one is different code, but this one is just an example, right? So what we will do is that the system will create containers called cases for each of the participants and then connect their demographic information to those folders and then also their responses. So I'm going to show you how to do. You go to next. Here you indicate participant ID, right? Because that's what we're going to use to create the containers and do the connection. You go to next and then you have this information. Just showing that the system is going to connect these cases to participant responses based on question that were asked. So you click on next, you check aggregate coding from the chat. Another thing that you have to do is to check here, classify cases from classification columns. This will help you to connect participant demographics to the cases that you have. So it's very important to check that. And then when you finish, you go to auto code. As you can see here, when we go to cases, you can see that I have a case for each of the participants. And then when you go to classification, I have a container that has all the participant demographics. When you double click on this one, you see all participant demographics here. We go to classification sheet, you have the ethnicity, age, gender, years of experience. You also have the participant ID here. So this is how you do it. So you see the process. I hope this one was helpful. If you have any question, put it in the comment section and I'll be happy to address them for you. Thank you for your time.